Hello, good morning to you. We're here again to further explain the POI Simple Agenda so we can have a greater understanding of what Pastor Osage Izayamu has in store for Edo people if given the opportunity. And with us today to do just that for us is the Edo South coordinator of the APC Campaign Council for the Edo 2020 governorship election. He's also the former minority whip of the House of Representatives in the person of Right Honorable Samson Osage. Welcome, sir.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure being here.
It's very wonderful to have you here with us, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, before we go on, can you just tell us a little about yourself so we're launching, let the people know you?
Yes, thank you very much. It is with my profound respect and honor to be part of this trip aimed at resuscitating governance in the Edo State in all aspects of human endeavor, in all sectors of our state's economy and the life of our state. I was first and foremost a member of the Edo State House of Assembly, elected in 1999 and re-elected in 2003, a two-time member of the Edo State House of Assembly. In 2007, I was elected to represent Odiomarumonde Federal Constituency, and that is the federal constituency of the candidate, Pastor Osage Izayamu. I was in the House of Representatives for 2 terms of 8 years. The last term of 4 years, I was the minority whip of the All Progressive Congress in the party. I have also served in corporate capacities in the federal institutions, and that is the Nigerian Communications Satellite Limited, as an executive director. I am a lawyer by training. I have been in public service and interested in public service to advance the cause of humanity and societal development. Because what is life generally if you do not put yourself in a position to render service to people and develop the environment? And I think that is the whole essence of a meaningful life. And that is why I have dedicated my life to the service of my people, the service of my state, the service of my community, and the service of my fellow human beings.
Thank you, sir. That's very wonderful. Before we go on, please be very well aware that we are on Facebook at Pastor Osage Izayamu and also on Twitter at POI Simple Agenda. You can be part of the show there. You can comment, you can ask questions, and we will do well to read them. I think you are aware and you're familiar with this, the POI Simple Agenda, because that's why we are here.
Yes, the POI Simple Agenda, which in all material particulars,
yes,
captures the manifesto of change for the All Progressive Congress, is our compass going forward into good governance. And it has been put together by the candidate of the party and party stalwarts in order to ensure that Edo people understands what our party, the APC, and its candidate has in stock for us in the next 4 years going into the future of our state when elected by the people of Edo State in the September 19th general election. And the philosophy behind this is to let people know that we are prepared to sign a social contract, giving this particular platform on the Simple Agenda as a basis upon which Edo people is to hold us responsible, is to hold the candidate and the party accountable to the promises we are making to Edo people. At the moment, even as this campaign ranges in Edo State, this is what has distinguished the APC and its candidate from the other candidates of other political parties seeking election in 2020.
Yes, sir. So it is no news that Pastor Osage Izayamu is a transparent man, giving us this to hold him accountable at the end of his term as governor, he's given the opportunity. Now you are aware and very familiar with this. What would you have to say about the area of security, given the current state of security in Edo State right now, and the rise in criminal activities, the rise in all sorts of fraudulent activities, and then how would we flush out criminals from this state?
Thank you very much. I want to state clearly that the Simple Agenda is an acronym for capturing the developmental goals of Edo people. And S stands for security. I stands for infrastructure. M stands for manpower development. B stands for public-private partnership. L stands for leadership by example. And E stands for employment and empowerment. Now, you will understand that the security and welfare of people is the primary responsibility of government. No wonder this agenda begins with an S. As of today, Edo State has come to its lowest ebb in terms of provision of security. There is a governance failure on the part of the incumbent government in the area of security. And that is why today you have kidnappings all over the place. Today you have armed robbery and banditry all over the place. And the government of the day is practically doing nothing about it. At the beginning of this administration, we tend to have a sigh of relief where we heard that a security outfit called Wabaisiga was put in place by this government. Little did you know that this outfit was meant to chase and intimidate and harass political opponents of government. That is not how a government that is responsible and responsive should deal with security issues in our state. It was in this state a judge of the High Court was kidnapped. It was in this state high-level prominent citizens and not-so-prominent citizens have been kidnapped and killed. It is in this state that thugs have taken over the streets, fighting political opponents, burning down vehicles, planting thugs in airports in order to cause mayhem, all targeted at political opponents. It is in this state that people are being killed and buried at shrines. And to be honest with you, this government has performed below expectation in this area. The simple agenda under Pastor Sagese Yabu has governed, we have promised and committed ourselves to the fact that within 6 months, the Pastor Sagese Yabu led administration will endeavor to flush out all criminals from all the nooks and crannies of Edo State. And what does that take? It's investment, huge investment in security, both in terms of manpower, both in terms of equipment, in terms of vehicles. And in doing this, there shall be a combined effort of all security architecture in the state. A well-funded security, funded security architecture that will take into cognizance the peculiarities of our environment and the role of traditional institutions in ensuring that peace and security returns. I have no doubt in my mind that Pastor Sagese Iyamu will commit himself to ensuring that those citizens will sleep with their two eyes closed upon becoming governor of Edo State. I have no doubt in my mind that Edo farmers, Edo traders will travel on our highways and go to their farms without any fear of being kidnapped, either in their farms or on the highway. I have no doubt in my mind that Pastor Sagese Iyamu will judiciously utilize the security vote of the state and of the office of the governor to ensure huge investment in the procurement of vehicles, in the procurement of technologies, latest technologies in tracking down criminals, and encouraging all security agencies to ensure that they are on top of their game and that no criminal enters the shore of Edo State and returns safe. Yeah. He is committed to that. The APC government is committed to that. The APC members and leadership, they are committed to that. Security and welfare is the primary responsibility of government. And any government who fails to do that, such as we have under Governor Godwin Opaseki, is not worthy of being re-elected. And that is why this campaign is centered around issues, first of which is security. Pastor Sagese Iyamu and the APC, come 2020, will commit government resources in huge numbers into fighting insecurity and ensuring that those charged with responsibility of law enforcement, of guaranteeing a crime-free society, are not only just encouraged, they are given the right tools and provided the right environment to work. And that is why you have S, which means security, as the very first fundamental goal of this administration of the administration of Pastor Osagie Eze Ihiamu come November 2020.
Thank you, sir. We have seen that education is key and the children are the future of tomorrow, but in this current administration, they have been completely ignored. They have been completely ignored and put by the side. So what does the POIC agenda have in store for education in the aspect of employing more teachers? Some schools have as low as 4 teachers in a whole secondary school. And what is the plan to employ teachers, to empower them, to pay them proper salaries, and to encourage them to train these children properly?
Thank you so much. You will agree with me that the state of education in a good state at the moment is perilous. Edo witnessed progress in this education last under Governor Adams Oshomole. And since Adams Oshomole left office, the public infrastructures in our schools, which he put in place, have degenerated beyond recognition. So much so that there are very few schools that may have been built or renovated. No chairs, we still do not have chairs in schools that otherwise have chairs in the last 8 years of Governor Adams Oshomole. Today, what we have is that rather than recruit teachers, you know, to teach students in our schools, what we have is the recruitment of consultants to come from across the country, not even Edo State, to come and train teachers. And each of these consultants have been paid $1,500,000 for the purpose of training teachers and so on and so forth. Today, our students are all at home, our pupils are all at home, courtesy of the COVID-19 pandemic. While private schools are making efforts to teach their pupils and their students online, deploying the means of technology, the Edo public schools cannot teach their students online. And you wonder, how do you justify the huge investment in technology for Edo education? And that is what we call Edo Best. If what they have in place is Edo Best, I beg to disagree that that can be only Edo Worst. An education policy and practice that cannot adapt with the changing realities of the society, an education program that cannot adapt with the COVID-19 pandemic so as to continue to guarantee the teaching and learning of our students, even under the regime of lockdown across the country and across the state, then it is a worthless investment that has been made in that sector. So, for the simple agenda under Pastor Osagie Eze Ihiamu has covered, I can assure you that modern technologies for teaching and learning will be deployed to our schools. Teachers will be recruited, because what we have today is one teacher, one school. Teachers will be recruited across the state in order that our students are able to get teachers in all the subjects. In some schools today, you have less than 4 students, 4 teachers in a whole school from class 1 to class to SS1, GSS1 to SS2. That is not healthy for our educational system. The teachers will be trained and retrained in a manner that will make them bring their training to be useful to the educational sector, to the education of our children in the school. Not what we are having today, where huge sums of money have been purportedly invested in training of teachers, a training which has not been able to impact positively on the learning and training of our children. So for us, what will it be? POI simple agenda. The administration will embark on massive training of teachers, will embark on guaranteeing allowances outside their salary for teachers in order to encourage them to do well. We will embark on regular inspection of schools, because in those days there used to be inspection of schools, where you have inspectors who visit school to know the state of affairs in terms of schools infrastructure, in terms of manpower development, in terms of output of what the teachers are teaching the students. The simple agenda will concentrate on massive infrastructure in our education, rebuilding our schools that have become dilapidated, because there was a Red Bull revolution which transformed over 70% of our public schools. And now with the expansion of the population of our people, we now discover that the schools we have in Edo State are grossly inadequate. We have paid visit to a number of new communities, new settlements, where you don't have school infrastructure, where you don't have health infrastructure. The simple agenda of the Pastor Eze Iyabo administration come November 2020, will take into cognizance areas and new towns and satellite communities that have sprung up without education facilities. For example, in Okpara bypass houses, in the Upper Sakoma bypass houses, Sapero bypass houses. These are new settlements in Benisi that do not have public schools. Now, under the EOI simple agenda, we are going to embark on massive reconstruction of schools already in existence and new schools in new areas where there are no school infrastructure.
All right, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Before we continue, we want to go on a break. And I want to talk about funding. The EOI simple agenda is very beautiful. But in all truth, we know that money is a big factor. Considering that the current governor, the current government has really drained the state of funds. So how are we going to raise funds for this? So we'll be going on a short break now, and when we're back, we'll discuss on funding. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Do you want to do how many more minutes you want to have?
Welcome back. We are still on the POI simple agenda, and here with us is Honorable Honorable Samson Osagie. Sorry for that, Honorable Samson Osagie. And we're planning on talking of the plan for funding for the POI simple agenda, considering the current state of the state. How are we going to raise funds to take care of all of that?
Yeah, it is true that the current government has plunged Edo State into serious debt crisis with over $280 million debt overhang on the state economy. But thank God that the government is continuing and our human and natural resources which Edo State was reputed for will still be available by the time he meets with us. And that is why in the simple agenda you have public-private partnership. And the intention of deploying public-private partnership is to ensure that government creates a nimble environment for some of the programs it is putting in place to be done in conjunction with the private sector. And that will have a multiplier effect on the entire economy. When government involves the private sectors into driving its development agenda, then you can have a robust economy that can put food on the table for virtually everyone. And in terms of funding, I believe that so much misapplication of funds have been done, you know, by this current administration. And I believe that there will be need to look into some of these areas where wastages have been done, where recoveries can be made, in order to ensure that Edo people get value for their money and for their taxes. It is the right of Edo people to know how their money is being spent, how it was being spent, and how the spending have been patterned on their life. And I tell you that Edo is ordinarily not a worst state. But under this administration, a lot of wastages have occurred, and those wastages will be blocked. Edo people are very low-abiding people. They have been paying their taxes in other circumstances that have not been congenial. However, the Pastor Ezeyamu administration will devise all means possible to ensure that other sources of revenue, other than federal allocation and internally generated revenue, are embarked upon in order to ensure that there is enough funds to provide for the programs it is putting in place. And I believe that within the first 4 years, Edo people will have a sigh of relief from a government that is currently being deceitful and wasteful of the revenue of our state. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. You have heard it all. Edo people, the ball is in your court. Vote wisely.
Vote your hand. You capture that?
Thank you, guys. Set up for the next one. Set up.